the number one heat wave, August Rush!
August Rush is a 10-year-old kid. He doesn't know who his parents are and wants to find them. And it's the power of music that brings this family together. The story begins on a rooftop in New York.
Can you hear that?
What is that?
It's a wish.
Well, it's a marvelous night for a moon dance with the stars up above in your eyes.
Jonathan Rhys Meyers is Lewis, the lead singer of an Irish band.
You do some singing in the film.
Mm-hmm.
You must have some sort of singing background. Were you in a band or anything? Or
I've never sung in a band or anything like that, but I like singing.
You sounded good.
Thank you.
And you're on the soundtrack too, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, you acted like it was a surprise. Did they tell you?
I don't think I'll be performing at the VMAs or anything.
Okay.
Keri Russell is Lila, a concert cello player. The two share one passionate night together, but then they're separated. Their child grows up alone, and more than 10 years later, they're all still trying to find each other. Lila tries getting help from a social worker, played by Terrence Howard.
Why is it so important that you want him now?
I've always wanted him. I've waited 11 years, 2 months, and 15 days to find out that he's alive.
We first met you as Felicity.
That's right.
But now you're all grown up, you're a mom.
That's right.
And so your baby, was it in June?
In June.
What's his name?
River.
River. So yeah. River's a couple of months old now?
He's 5 months old.
How's that going?
It's going well. I'm getting not as much sleep as I used to, but it's going.
Her son in the movie, August, comes to New York and meets a guy named Wizard. He's an old street musician played by Robin Williams.
So only some of us can hear it.
Only some of us are listening.
Do you think my parents are listening?
I hear you, kid.
What was it like doing a movie with Robin Williams? He must have been a riot on the set.
Yeah, he's got so much energy, but also he's such a funny guy, and he had the crew in stitches most of the time. It was like a sort of backstage pass to one of his comedy shows. But then putting him inside Wizard, who's lost that. He's lost that, his musical touch that he used to have. And so I think Robin Williams plays that really well.
You gotta love music more than you love food, more than life, more than yourself.
Do you have any sort of background in music before this role?
I mean, my parents aren't musicians or anything like that, but I played the clarinet beforehand for a bit, so I guess that helped, maybe. But
did you actually learn to play
the
guitar?
Yeah, about 5 or 6 months, I think, before I picked up the guitar and started to learn the songs that I had to do.
I was having to learn the cello, obviously, him the guitar, and I would say, Freddie, oh my God, that is so not hard compared. I could like fake guitar any day of the week. Like the cello is so much harder. And we would just joke about that.
So are you gonna set up in Washington Square Park or Central Park or something?
Just for money, just extra money. You know,
yeah,
to pay
you gotta
pay
get
the
some
house,
extra cash.
Whatever,
you know?
I have a kid now.
Yeah.
Like someone's calling out to me. Writing it all down is like I'm calling back to them.
Ooh.
The ones who gave me the music.
This is a film that's, you know, there's a lot of socially important, very hard-hitting films out there. Mm-hmm. This isn't this movie. This is about creativity and hope and love.
This is kind of like a real-life modern fairy tale.
Yeah. I mean, I think it's about, you know, just believing in yourself and being true to yourself, which August does.
How'd you learn how to play like that in 6 months?
Juilliard.
Juilliard?
Yes, sir. I have my own concert tonight.
Along his journey, August enrolls at Juilliard, New York's famous music school, which helps bring them all a step closer to giving this modern fairy tale a happy ending. For Backstage, I'm Blake Hayes.